Hi there, I'm Jace Lindgren, a solutions engineer at Perforce Software, and today I'm going to be taking you through how to add an extra storage volume as well as automatic backups to your DigitalOcean Perforce image. So I'm assuming for this that you have already created a Helix Core DigitalOcean droplet. You can do that by going up to Create a Droplet and then choosing from the marketplace the Perforce Helix Core image. So I'm assuming you've already done that. And now we have our instance up and running, our droplet as it's called on DigitalOcean. And the first thing we're going to do is to connect via the console. So I'm going to click here to launch the online console. You could also do this through SSH, but I'm just doing it this way to keep it simple. When you log in here, you will see this message of the day. And if you have a recent version of the Helix Core SDP image, you will have this extra message down here at the bottom that says DigitalOcean setup. We highly recommend that you set up a separate depot volume for your DigitalOcean server. This will make backups easier and potentially save you a lot of money as your depots grow. To quickly and easily set up a depot volume and automatic backups, run this script right here and follow the instructions. All right, so what we can do here is come up and run this script. So I will just copy this path here with Control C, and then I'll paste it in here. This script will give explanations of what it's going to do at each step along the way. So this first one here explains that this script will assist in transitioning your Helix Core depot data off of your root volume and onto a dedicated volume. It's important to note that in order to do this, it is going to shut down your Helix Core server for a little bit while it sets up the new volume, moves data over, remaps some paths, and then starts it back up again. What that means is if anyone is currently logged in, like if you've already given people logins to your server and they're actively trying to submit or sync files, they're going to run into errors and it's going to crash partway through because the server is going to shut down. So just be sure that nobody is using it right now. Let all of your users know, hey, you need to stop this for a little bit. I have to do some maintenance on the server. If this is a brand new server that you've just set up, you can just go ahead, keep using this script. If you've already been using this and you already have data on it, I would strongly recommend that you follow these steps here and make a checkpoint, create a snapshot through DigitalOcean so that if the worst possible thing happens, if for some reason things get totally screwed up, you could go back to that snapshot and restore your server from there. So if you're going to do that, just exit out of this script and then run this script that it mentions here, which is for doing a daily checkpoint. You'll run this daily checkpoint script as the Perforce user. And then in DigitalOcean, you'll go and make a snapshot, take a live snapshot of your whole instance. So you can use that to get back to it and restore that snapshot if you have to. I don't think that you will, but always better safe than sorry. Assuming this all looks good and you've already done that, you can click Y to continue and hit enter. This next step says that it's going to prompt you to authenticate DOCTL. So DOCTL is the command line client for DigitalOcean. What this script is doing is actually running DOCTL on the instance itself. So you don't have to install anything else or configure anything else yourself. But in order to authenticate, it needs a DigitalOcean API token. So there are steps here of how to do that, but I will go through this with you right now. So the first thing is we go back to our DigitalOcean dashboard here. And on the left-hand navigation, we'll see down at the bottom, there is this API. We'll click on that. This will bring us here to our personal access tokens. You can see I have a few already. If you have not made any tokens yet, you would not see anything here. And then you'll come up to this button, generate new token. You'll give it a name. So this could be, my DO backup token or whatever you want to call it. Doesn't really matter. That's just for your own records. I would set your expiration here to no expire. The reason for that is that this script is going to set up not only a separate volume, which it needs to do using DOCTL right now, but it's also going to use this key to do snapshots of your instance every night. And so if this ticket ever expires, if this token ever expires, those backups won't be happening anymore. Those snapshots of the storage won't be happening anymore. And we do need to check this write permission here because, like I said, it's going to be creating snapshots. That's a write operation. So we need to do that. Then you'll hit generate token. It will generate it here. And this token is going to be displayed right here and copy it. But this will never be shown again. So if you don't copy this right now and save it somewhere, you know, paste it into Notepad or something so you can put it into your DigitalOcean instance. If you don't do that, you can never get this back again. So in that case, your only option will be to come here, delete it, and generate a new one, or hit this regenerate token. When you hit regenerate token, it will invalidate any past tokens. So if you've already used this and then you come back and say regenerate, all those old ones will stop working and it'll issue you a new one. So what we'll do is we'll just copy this. And don't worry, the fact that you're seeing my token is fine because I'm going to delete this as soon as we're done here. But normally, don't let anybody else see this token. And with that, we're going to go back into here. It explains all those same steps that we just did. We're going to save that somewhere safe. There's a link to their docs if you need those. And then down here, it says, please authenticate DOCTL for use with your DigitalOcean account. You can generate a token with the control panel here. Enter your access token. Note, you will not see what is pasted or typed in. So if I come right here and I hit Command V, I don't see anything that it has pasted, and I'll hit Enter. It's going to check if that token was okay. It was, and then we're going to move on. If I pasted that wrong or I typed it wrong, if I was trying to type it by hand, it would tell me no and ask me again for it. So you'll get a second chance if you mess that up. But just note, you're not going to see any text there. All right, the next question is, what size in gigabytes would you like your new depot volume to be? This can be increased later, but this can't be decreased. By default, this is going to be 100 gigs. I'm going to leave it on that for this example, but you could, of course, make this larger if you know for sure, oh yeah, I'm going to put a lot more data in that right away. Otherwise, you can expand that later on. We have a video on our YouTube channel that talks about how to expand storage just generally on any Linux instance like this one. So you can go check that out for instructions on that to do later. You'll have to do stuff in the command line again, but it's relatively straightforward. So I'm going to leave this on 100. And then you can give a name for this Helix Core Depot volume. This name has to be unique per DigitalOcean region. So whatever region your instance is in, you just have to use a name that's unique. And this is the name that DigitalOcean will call this volume. So if I leave this on the default and hit enter, it's going to create my new volume. And this is using that DigitalOcean API on the back end. So you can see it's doing some steps here. If I actually go back to my DigitalOcean account here, and if I go back to my instance, so I just clicked on my project here. If I go to my instance, I click on that. If I look now at the volumes tab on the left, I'll actually see Helix Core Depot. It's created this 100 gig volume called Helix Core Depot because that's what I entered up here. So just to clarify that all of this stuff, it's doing that on the back end, the same as you could have done yourself here, but it's just doing that automatically for you. So it is worth noting that when it says this name must be unique per DigitalOcean region, that's unique per region for your account. So not unique globally across all users, but just for yourself. And okay, you can see it goes through these steps. The important part is just seeing that it's verified everything completely. What it's doing is it's creating this new volume, setting up the file system on it, and then it's also copying any files that you currently have in your depot over onto this new volume so that it will be used. And when we start back up, all that data will be there in the new location where it needs to be. Next, below this line, it explains that a new crontab entry has been created for the Perforce user that will create a checkpoint of the database and then snapshot the Helix Core Depot volume on a daily basis. So between the checkpoints and those snapshots, you can restore from a snapshot and then use those checkpoints to restore your server completely from backup if something terrible should happen and your whole server goes kaput. This script is automatically going to create a new snapshot every night, and it will automatically prune any older snapshots up to a certain number. And that's what we're going to set down below. Down here, it just explains a little bit about snapshots, how you can find those in the DigitalOcean console. And you can edit this maximum number of snapshots it's going to keep later. To do that, you actually have to go into your terminal here and edit this text file here, this bash script, to change the max snapshots value. That's a little bit more advanced, so ideally we're going to pick a number that we like right here. This also explains a little bit about if you want to disable this automatic snapshotting altogether, you can edit the cron tab entry and just remove this line here. Again, a little bit more advanced. Let's just talk quickly about pricing for this, just so you understand it. So this is as of February 2024, but you can check this yourself by going to DigitalOcean's docs. But volumes cost 10 cents per gigabyte, as you can see here. That's similar to a gigabyte, so I usually just call it that, even though technically they're just slightly different from each other. So 10 cents per gigabyte per month. So if we multiply that by 100 to get 100 gigabyte volume, that's $10 per month. If I go to the snapshot pricing page, these are 6 cents per gigabyte per month for droplets and the same for volumes. So in this case, we're making snapshots of volumes. So that means that this is going to be 6 cents per gigabyte per month per snapshot. So if you have 7 snapshots of a volume, that's 100 gigs, that's going to be $6 per month per snapshot. Multiply 6 by 7, that's $42 per month for all of those. So just keep that in mind. Having more snapshots gives you further back in history if you don't notice a problem for a few days, but it does cost you this 6 cents per gigabyte. So just keep that in mind. Definitely keep at least one snapshot just for safety, maybe 2 or 3. Just so you have something to go back to, just make sure that you're okay with that cost and nothing catches you by surprise. And of course, you could go in and manually delete the snapshots if you needed to as well. So down here, it's asking us to enter the maximum number of snapshots you would like to keep. This must be an integer of 1 or higher. So by default, this is going to be 7, which means we're going to make a snapshot every day for a week. And then after that week, when we make the next snapshot, it will automatically delete the oldest one of those previous ones, and it'll keep going like that. You could also make this much smaller, like say only 3. If you're like, nope, if anything goes wrong, 3 days worth of backups is going to be fine for me. Either way, you can hit enter here. And you'll see new drive setup complete. It will give you the volume's name, its size, the mount points, the device ID, some various other information like this. It'll remind you that you can check this. It confirms here that the latest 3 snapshots will be stored on DigitalOcean because 3 is what I entered up here. And then down here, it explains again about advanced users. If you want to disable or change the timing of the automated snapshots, you can edit the cron tab, which you can do by running cron tab-e. In your terminal here. That's a little bit more advanced. Please reach out. Let me know if you want me to cover some more stuff about that. I'll leave a comment on this video. Let us know. But hopefully you can just leave this, let it do those backups every night, and then you can come check those in your DigitalOcean dashboard and just make sure those backups are happening. And hopefully, if everything goes well, you don't ever have to use them. They're really just there for emergencies. The last thing it says here is that this script will now prevent itself from being run again. What that means is if I came and tried to run this add depot volume script again, and I hit enter here, it's going to say no such file or directory. What it's done is it's just renamed the file to something else so that you don't accidentally try and run that again. Just as a little safety feature. But if you ever had to, you could go back and just manually rename it. It's still in the same folder where it was. So now, let's do this. If I type df-h, so df space dash h, this is going to show me all of my disks on my instance and how much storage is on all of them. So I do this and you'll see that I now have this new mount point here called HX depots that I didn't have before that has 100 gigs. It's used 892 megs out of 100 gigs. So I basically have my full 100 gigs left. You can see I'm using 1% of it. So before, everything was just being stored on the root volume, which is much smaller, 24 gigs in this case. And to increase that is much more expensive on DigitalOcean, whereas to expand an external storage volume like this is much cheaper. One thing worth noting here is that from the DigitalOcean console, this shows you the total size of your volume, but doesn't show you how much of it you've used. Similarly, in graphs and also in P4 admin, you will not see the space on this volume by default. So the way to check that is to go back into your console again and then run this command df space dash h. So in this case, df is for disk free, I believe is what that stands for. By default, just df by itself will show you all of the storage space in bytes, which is a little bit hard, at least for me, to read as a human. So the dash h makes it human readable. So then it will actually show you in gigs and megs and kilobytes in certain cases. So df space dash h is a nice easy way to come in here and just check how much space do I have left. And if I'm starting to run low, that's when you should check out our other video on our YouTube channel about expanding the storage space on your volume. I hope this was helpful, and I will see you again in the next one.